The virtual cam option in Ecamm Live lets you use all of your scenes, graphics, and overlays, and whatever else, with Zoom. But unfortunately, it doesn't send an audio signal. Now, I must have been out of the loop on Loopback because I've only recently discovered it as an awesome tool for looping your audio back into Zoom. So let's loop back around and talk about what's so great about Loopback. But first, this is not a sponsored video. I did purchase Loopback at the full price, and unfortunately, it's not free software. I purchased it for, I think $100 was the price at the time, which can seem a little steep because $100 definitely is not cheap. However, if you're somebody who uses Zoom and Ecamm and encounters this problem a lot of needing to move your audio from Ecamm to Zoom, that $100 can really be a lifesaver. And I know for me, it really was, because I kept having this problem over and over again. And fortunately, Loopback is not a subscription plan. It's a single payment price situation. So once you pay once, you just have the software forever. And basically what Loopback does is it lets you route virtually audio sources all within your computer. So you can have an output going into any input, you can mix and match things and merge things. Basically anything you can think of in terms of routing audio within your system, you can do. Now it is for Mac only, and when you install it, it's going to ask you to do something that feels a little bit strange at first, but I promise it's okay. I didn't expect this or know this when I first installed it a few months ago, so I don't have footage of it, but when you install Loopback, a thing's gonna pop up that says you need to reboot your computer into safe mode, and it's gonna give you some very simple instructions on some permissions that you need to grant for Loopback. This feels very shady at first. You just download something from the internet and now it's like, yeah, go into, you know, the root of your computer and grant access to all this stuff. But all that you're doing is you're giving Loopback permission to modify all the audio within your system. It's not touching anything else. And the instructions to do it are very simple and very clear. But if you've never done something like that before, like I hadn't, it might feel a little bit strange, but I'm just reassuring you, it is okay and you won't break anything. And the reason you need to do that is so that you do give Loopback permission to just take control of all the audio, or at least it has the ability to take control, because if you're not using it, it can just disappear into the background as much as you want and not even be used. But as soon as you need it, you can bring it up and then explore the magic of Loopback. Now, I was able to get around this for a while by using the Rodecaster Pro as my main audio source. So that is where all my audio is going into. And I was even having my system audio run into the Rodecaster and then routing it back into the system to use with Zoom. And that helped me to get some audio from Ecamm into Zoom, but it still caused some problems because routing the system audio and then back into Zoom, if people in the Zoom meeting needed to speak and have their voices heard, it just got a little confusing, and Loopback makes things a little simpler. So if you're trying to play Ecamm sound effects, or you're trying to play a video file through Ecamm, or anything where you need to get the audio from Ecamm into Zoom in a full mix situation, this is definitely the easiest way to do it. So right here is my Ecamm Live, and if I click on output, then I can see that the virtual cam is turned on. But like I mentioned at the beginning of this video, virtual cam only affects video, not audio. So here's Loopback, and what this does is it lets you create a virtual audio device. And this is pretty much what we're going to create, so I'll walk you through step by step. It can look as simple or advanced as you want. Obviously, if you're looking at this right here, it looks a little funky. It almost looks like you're doing some Blender animation or some DaVinci Resolve editing. But all we're gonna do is create a new virtual device. And this is the basic setup that you're gonna end up with. But before we jump into that, I'm gonna change the name of this to Ecamm Virtual Audio. Exclamation point. And so what we're looking at here is we've got different audio sources, or we have the ability to add different audio sources. We've got our output channels, so where's that audio going? And we also have the ability to monitor our audio, and you can just keep adding in new sources and all kinds of new stuff. This default pass-through option we don't really need, so I'm gonna click on it and delete it. And now we have no audio sources. So I'm gonna add in Ecamm Live, not the Notes app. Okay, I'm gonna add in Ecamm Live. Remember when I said you could do anything? Apparently you could have the Notes app. So we've got Ecamm here. However, you're gonna notice there's still no audio showing up, which is why this can be so frustrating, because in my Ecamm on my computer, I'm seeing the Rodecaster audio bouncing. I'm recording this into Ecamm right now, so clearly the audio is there. If I were to stream to YouTube or Twitch or wherever, the audio would be there, but it's just getting it out to Zoom that doesn't work. Now there's this little options box down here that says mute when capturing. I'm gonna uncheck that. And now we're gonna add in a second audio source. Since all of my audio is running through the Rodecaster Pro, I'm gonna add the Rodecaster Pro stereo as an audio source. And in your situation, just select whichever audio source you're using. So if you're using a different interface like the Focusrite, you'll be able to select that. If you're just using a single USB mic, whatever your audio source is, that's what you select right here. And if you're in an advanced audio situation, I would think something maybe involving music, you can also add more than just one other source in addition to Ecamm. Now the Rodecaster doesn't have the same mute option, so we're just gonna keep that there at 100%. And now this is sort of the weird thing that's happening is we see both of these are automatically going into output channels 1 and 2. You see left and right stereo signals. And what's strange is Ecamm is still showing nothing, but the Rodecaster is showing audio because that's where the audio is coming from. And so the simplest way I can think of explaining it is that basically Loopback is taking Ecamm, which is not sending out an audio signal, and then it's taking the Rodecaster, and it's just sort of smashing them all together and throwing them out as a new source. And I have named that source Ecamm Virtual Audio. So now if I go into Zoom and I open up Preferences, you can see my Ecamm Virtual Audio that we just created is right there. One other quick tip, if you're not already doing this, when you're in your Zoom audio settings, you can select the option that says Show in Meeting Option to Enable Original Sound. And then when you do that, let's start a meeting real quick. All right, so here's my Zoom meeting. It's infinitely great, as you can see. Because I selected that option, right up here it says turn on original sound. If I click that, now it's gonna take away all of Zoom's processing and it's just going to be my original audio. So sometimes Zoom tries to be helpful by deciding it's gonna cancel out echoes and it's gonna reduce background noise and do all this stuff. But if you've already got a decent audio setup, that can sometimes cause more harm than good. And so by turning that off, now you're putting everything into your control. And if you've got a decent audio setup, that can actually make things sound a lot better and a lot more clear. It's not gonna be perfect, of course, because it is still Zoom, but it's gonna sound significantly better. And just remember though, you're gonna have to turn this on or off every time you start a meeting. So by default, your original audio will be turned off every time you start a meeting or every time you join a meeting, and you'll have to click that button every single time. And so this right here is the basic setup that you need to send a virtual audio signal out to Zoom using Loopback. And hopefully, as you sort of noticed by me accidentally even adding in the Notes app, the options are basically limitless. So kind of like Ecamm, one of my favorite things about it is that it can be so simple, or it can be crazy complex if you want it to. If you have an idea of like, could I do this or that? There's probably a way to do it in Ecamm. Loopback is kind of the same thing, where it can be very simple and very basic and you can just send one signal to one place. Or if you have some crazy idea of like, I need to route this here and send this here and mix these two together and put those there, you can totally do it. And you can create basically an unlimited number of virtual devices. So if you're using Loopback with different applications, maybe you've got Ecamm audio for Zoom, but you've got other applications for other things that you do, you can just keep those there and just switch between them at any time, or they will all just show up as sources in your application. And as I mentioned, I kind of live on Zoom and Ecamm is one of my favorite tools. So here's a few other Zoom and Ecamm videos. If you like them, you could leave them on loop until you want to come back and watch more videos, until you want to loop back. Loop back. I'm feeling a little loopy from these puns today.